Hello, welcome to Kitchen Quarantine. Today we're gonna realize cauliflower steak with cauliflower puree, pickled cauliflower, and some pomegranate. Let's start. So when you're gonna realize the cauliflower steak, first of all, you cut the cauliflower. I like in this way, you know, so I got all this nice design. I score it as well, if you see. You do one side and then the other. So it's gonna looks like the marks of the meat, and it's gonna help cooking all the way. So from one cauliflower, was a small one, I took out two nice steak. You want that to stay all together, and this is gonna be a lot of trimming. All the trimming is gonna be like all floret like this. So I slice some of them. I'm gonna pickle. I'm gonna use like a garnish, and the rest of them, I just gonna cut small pieces, and I'm gonna make out of them a caramelized cauliflower puree. So once you do all of this, I did already in advance, just place in the pan a little bit of oil and we start to cook slowly. As you can see, our cauliflower is starting to get color. I add a clove of garlic as well. Just keep stirring, just keep an eye here, we don't want to get too bad. Just keep cooking until it gets nice and caramelized. Now that it's getting there, I add some clarified butter. If you don't have clarified butter, you can use normal butter. Just you need to be more careful because clarified butter can reach higher temperature without bark. Normal butter is better not. So just keep an eye, keep stirring, it will be more color. So now it got the color that we want. You see, nice and very brown. It's not bad, but you know, if you keep there, that's like nice caramelized, like brown. So if you keep more, it will be a bit bitter. Doesn't matter if it's not, there is some pieces still white, because they all cook through, they're gonna blend and you're gonna come a nice homogeneous cook color. So our puree is done. If you see, it's nice color, like a caramel color, nice consistency. You can try if you put in a plate on a container and stay up, it's not too runny. You know, you always add a little bit slowly by slowly, and make sure there's enough air and space in the blender for make it work properly. Otherwise, it's gonna overheat. Just gonna put here. I'm gonna save for later. So for cauliflower, hot pan. Hot oil, cauliflower down. Make sure it goes color everywhere. You can press down a little bit so the oil is going all over the surface. You're gonna just give one side nice color. Then flip in a tray, keep cooking, finish to cook in the oven, and you can finish in the pan. Meanwhile, our cauliflower is cooking. I'm gonna open the pomegranate. So there is a lot of technique to do it. This is like a technique that one my friend from Egypt, where it's very common, the pomegranate, he showed me. So you cut the head and the husk, and then you follow this line. You follow the natural cut of the pomegranate. So another way, but I believe it's a bit wrong, is to cut in half and just knock it down with a spoon. Right? Now you're gonna have all the segments. So my cauliflower be in the oven, check with a small knife or with a cake tester. So you want still al dente, so the knife has to go through. This is still a bit under. Now I'm gonna put in the oven just for a little longer, put some mozzarella on, or if you want bechamel, just let caramelize, and then we're gonna start plating. So our cauliflower is done. You see, nice caramelized, and mozzarella is nice and melt. So now let's start to plating. So this is our dish for today. I hope you enjoy. If you have any question or any doubt, just write on the comment. This dish actually can be easily vegan. It's already vegetarian. Just if you skip to put butter on the puree, just use oil, and so it can be easily vegan. Thanks for watching. Thanks for the sponsor of Kore, and stay safe.